my name's Anne, and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we're gonna play with this new baby right here. It's the new Morphe Time Jaclyn Hill The Vault Collections. I haven't swatched, I haven't touched these palettes since I got them, so I'm gonna do this with you on camera. I'm gonna do some quick swatches of these palettes, and I'm gonna tell you some quick information regarding these palettes. Then I'm gonna do four looks using these palettes for you, one for each palette. And at the end, I will tell you which one I love, which one is worth buying. So it's gonna be a long video, but I will put the timestamp in the description box down below for each palette. You can skip over and just watch whatever that you want. Since this video is already long enough, I already do my face, my base, and my eyebrow off camera. And then I will do my liner or my lashes off camera during the video, so we don't have to drag this video like way too long. I'm just focusing on using these palettes today, but I will put everything I use in the description box down below so you can check it out. Without dragging this video any longer, let's go ahead and get started. First, let's get some information regarding these palettes. The shades in the Vault collections are the shade that Jaclyn Hill created with Morphe that did not make into the original palette that she created. So Jaclyn Hill and Morphe decided to release the rest of the shades since the first original palette was a huge success. So according to Jaclyn Hill, these shades had the same formulation, the same breath, and the same pigmentations as the first original palette. So here is the package of the Vault collection look like. It's just a shiny white box. In the front, it has the Morphe Time Jaclyn Hill. And in the back, it has a beautiful, gorgeous pictures of her. And again, some information regarding the palette itself. The Vault collection retails for $49. It's available on Morphe.com, Morphe Store, on Ulta.com and Ulta Store. If you want to get the whole actual box, it's only available on Morphe.com and Morphe Store. On Ulta, you only get each individual palette. You cannot get the whole package like this. And each palette retails for $15, so you get a little bit discount when you get the whole box. And on Morphe.com and Morphe Store, you can use any discount code and get extra 10% off. So it's always good to save some money. So let's jump into the box. And here is what the actual Vault looked like. It's just a stiff cardboard, like shiny stiff cardboard. And right here, you can actually see the four palettes in this entire collection. And another good thing about this is that you can actually see the name of each palette right here. And on these, you can actually see the color theme of each palette, so you don't have to go and open each individual palette to see which one you're gonna use. You can actually see it right here. And here is the ribbon that it came with the box. You can actually just pull it and the palette came off. And again, on the actual palette itself, it's just a white shiny cardboard, very stiff. I like it better than the original one because the original one is not shiny like this and it gets dirty very easy. And each palette like this is very easy to travel with. Just pop in your purse or pop it in your carrier and then you. So let's look inside the actual palette. Each palette comes with a good side mirror. It's different than her original one because the original palette did not come with a mirror. And another good thing is that it has the shade name on the actual palette itself. And each palette has 10 shadows and it retails for $15, so it's a really good deal. It's really affordable palette. So right now I'm gonna show you a close-up look of each palette and show you the swatches of these. So this is the first one. It's called Calm and Gorgeous. It's a warm tone palette. And here is the swatch for the Almond Gorgeous palette. First, I have VIP, Access, Guild Trip, Koi, Agent, Top Secret, Smooth Criminal, Secure, Proud, and Classified. The second one is called Ring the Alarm. It looks like this. It's another warm tone palette. And here is the swatch for the Ring the Alarm. First, I have Lolly, Rush, On Camera, Boom, Alert, Bomb Ass, Siren, Mugshot, Framed, and Secret. The third one is called Bling Boss. It's a cool tone palette. And here is the swatch for the Bling Boss palette. First, I have Bling Bling, Hush Hush, Jam, Pizzard, Mystique, Sparks, Glitz and Glam, Rockstar, Bossy, and Berry Treasure. Last but not least, we have Dark Magic. And here is the swatch for the Dark Magic. First, I have Poof, Power Cut, Trickery, Division, Potion, Busted, Inside Job, Mojo, and Temptress. Enough with the talking and start blending. I don't know what look I'm going for, but I will do a more detailed look using this palette in my upcoming video as well. So stay tuned for that. First, I'm gonna start with Almond Gorgeous palette. First, with my Morphe R37, I'm gonna start first with Excess, this shade right here. And I'm gonna start this at my crease. I'm just gonna go quick with these steps so it doesn't drag this video way too long. Now, with my Morphe E18, I'm gonna bring Excess to my lower lash as well. Next, with my Morphe M441, I'm gonna take Agent, it's this shade right here. Agent is a matte saffron. I'm just bringing this a little bit lower than Accent. With my Morphe E36, I'm gonna bring Agent down to my lower lash line as well. Next, with my Morphe M506, I'm gonna take Smooth Criminal, is this shade right here. And I'm just gonna darken my crease and add a corner a little bit. With my Morphe M432, I'm gonna run Smooth Criminal on my lower lash line. Shutterstock music. For the lid, I'm gonna use Classify. It's this shade right here. And I'm gonna use it with my MAC 242. But I'm gonna wet my brush first. And I'm gonna apply this on my lid. I'm gonna try to apply this with my finger. Classify is a shimmering burnt gold. Shimmering shades, I got a little bit far out, but I can just dust it up real quick. It's no big deal, but it looks really nice. I did not have any problem with the matte shade, a little bit far out from the shimmery shade. So I'm just gonna go back to Smooth Criminal and just kind of blend out the edge. I just want a little bit more pop in the center of my eyes, so I'm gonna go with Koi. Right here is this shade right here. This one is a glittery gold sheen. I'm gonna use my finger and apply it at the center of my eyes. Just a little bit, just give it a pop. Just kind of open up the eyes a little bit. I'm gonna apply my lashes and then I'll be right back. All right guys, this is my first look. What do you guys think? These matte shades in this palette, they just blend out so easily, no fall out, no kickback or anything in the pan. But the shimmer that I used, this one and this one, I did not get a good payoff with a wet brush. So I used my finger instead and it turned out really good. Let's just go ahead and move on to the second look. For the second look, I'm gonna start with Ring the Alarm palette. Let's start first with Rust. It's this shade right here. Rust is a matte amber. I'm also gonna bring Rust down to my lower lash. Next, I'm gonna take Frame. It's this shade right here. With my Morphe M433. And just apply it at my outer corner. And just darken the crease a little bit. Frame is a matte deep plum. So I'm just gonna apply this right here. Next, I'm gonna run Frame for my lower lash line as well. With this shade right here, it's called Bomb Ass. It's a gleaming hibiscus pink. I'm also gonna wet my brush. With this shade, it's such a beautiful shade. I'm loving this. Next, I'm gonna take this shade right here. It's called Siren, a shimmery plum, and I'm just gonna apply it right here where Bomb Ass and Frame Me. I'm just gonna apply my liners and my mascara and my lashes, and then I'll be right back. Alright guys, here is the complete look for the second look with the Ring the Alarm palette. I love this palette. It's really easy to use. It's blended out so perfectly. And the shade Bomb Mask that I used today, it did not have any fallout. So I'm loving this. For the third look, I'm gonna play with this baby right here. It's called Bling Boss. So first, I'm gonna go with Hush Hush. It's right here. I'm gonna use it with my MAC 224. Hush Hush is a matte lilac mauve. With this shade, I have a little bit kickback in the pan. The other palette, I did not have it. But I don't mind that as long as I don't have any fallout right here. So far everything blends out nicely. Just a little bit kicked back in the pan, but not on my face, so I don't really care for it. I'm gonna bring this shade down to my lower lash line as well. Next, I'm gonna go with Rockstar. It's this shade right here. I'm just gonna apply this at the outer corner. And just darken my crease a little bit. I'm also gonna run Rockstar to my lower lash line with my Morphe E36. With my MAC 239, I'm gonna go with this shade right here. It's called Mystic. Mystic is a matte blackberry, and I'm just gonna put it right here and outer corner, and just kind of connect them like at the top part. But mostly I leave this area right here, I leave this blank. With my Morphe M432, I'm gonna run Mystic on my lower lash line. For the lid, I'm gonna go with Jam. It's this shade right here. And I'm gonna use it wet. Jam is a really vibrant violet sheen. Wow, it's so pretty. Again, with these shimmering shades, I have a little bit of fallout. So if you do your face first, you shouldn't have any problem with this. Where the Mystic and Gem meet, I'm gonna use Berry Treasure. It's this shade right here. And I'm just gonna use that to just blend out the edge. With this palette, I suggest that you do your eyes first before you do your base. I will put on some lashes and then I'll be right back with you. Hello guys, this is the complete look for the Bling Boss palette. With this one, I had quite a bit of fallout. If you like to get this one, I suggest you do your eyes first before you do your face, otherwise it's gonna ruin your base. Other than that, the color is nice. It blends out beautifully. Let's go ahead and try on the fourth one, the Dark Magic palette. First, I'm gonna start with Potion. It's this shade right here. It's a matte avocado green. I haven't seen anything like this. I'm gonna use my Morphe R37. I'm gonna run it down to my lower lash line with my Morphe E36. Next, with my Morphe R39, I'm gonna use this shade right here. It's called Inside Job. Inside Job is a matte deep jade. Shutterstock music. For the lid, I'm gonna use Trickery. It's this shade right here. Trickery is a shimmering emerald, and I'm gonna use it wet as well. Yeah, I have a little bit far out with this one. I'm gonna apply my lashes and I'll be right back. This is a complete look for the dark magic. I like the matte shade. It plays out better than what I thought. But I do with the shimmering shades, I got a lot of fallout, like the Bling Boss palette. So keep in mind when you do your makeup. That's it for my video today. I hope you enjoyed this very, very long video. And after using all these four palettes, I did enjoy all of them. They very easy to work with. They blend out beautifully. Just the Bling Boss and the Dark Magic palette, they have a little bit fallout when it comes to the shimmering shades. But the Ring the Alarm and Arm and Gorgeous, they just blend out so beautifully. And the shimmering shade, I did not have any problem with them at all. There are some incredible unique shade in these palettes. And my favorites are the Ring the Alarm and Arm and Gorgeous. These two are my favorite in all of them. The Bling Boss and the Dark Magic. I would not pick these up if they're not including in all four. It's just these shades are not my everyday that I gonna pick them up and use them. So if you have to only pick one out of these four, I suggest that you go either with Arm and Gorgeous or Ring the Alarm. They're just so beautiful and it's so easy to use for every day. Bling Boss and Dark Magic. These two palettes are only good for like date night or any special event, or when you like really in the mood for playing with color. But for every day, I would not use these. Even though they have some shade you can use for every day, but not the whole entire palette. But overall, I would recommend any of these. It just depends on what you're gonna use them for or how you're gonna use them. Or you can just pick these four up for a good deal. Any of them, they're just so affordable, so easy to work with. The formulas are great. And they are very, very easy to travel with, and they just blend out so beautifully. Yeah, that is it, you guys. Let me know in the comment down below what look is your favorite. Which palette you're gonna pick up? I would love to know. And I would like to know what palette you want me to use in my next video. So that's it, you guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And hit that notification bell so it can let you know when I upload a new video. Like this one where I review new products or when I do a tips and trick video. I hope you have a great day and I talk to you soon.